with your baby's burp and thoughts. So let go into the flow of your state of deep relaxation as you prepare to explore the perfect daydream and paradise your mind takes you to now. Deeper. Deeper. From discomfort as a pleasure. During labor, your muscles will continue to push your baby down your birth canal. You are amazed as through the profound numbness, your baby down your birth canal. You are amazed as through the profound numbness, down your birth canal. Field of lightness, a magical cocoon of divine love and light. So relax, allowing my voice to make all the effort necessary for you. A profound presence of confident sensation continues to flow throughout your body down your birth canal. Your brain, what to do, how to do it. Lice is naturally numb and during labor. You are able to make out sensation.
Everything's fine. Everything's fine. No, it's not. My foot's ringing.
Down your birth. Thank you.
A big mistake, no doubt. But what are friends for?
Gosh, thanks, guys. Oh, where are we going, Gilly-Poo? Someplace far away from my dad.
Thank you. Thanks ever so much for the bag. It's exactly what I wanted.
Oh, forget it.
Oh,
it's wonderful of you to think of
me.
Oh, George.
Uh-oh, uh-oh, uh-oh.
I wish I had $1 million.
Hot dog!
A fast day, Captain Cook. You got your sea legs yet? Hello, Francis, mister. Hey, send me some of those pizza postcards, will you,
George? Hey, George, don't take any punk nickels.
Hey, George, suitcase is leaking.
Hey, Ernie. Hi, Ernie.
Hiya, George.
Hi, Bert.
George.
Hey, I'm a rich tourist today. How about driving me home in style?
Hop in, your highness. Hop in. And for the carriage, babe. I put on my hat.
Good afternoon, Mr. Bailey.
Hello, Violet. Hey, you look good. That's some dress you got on there.
This old thing? Well, I only wear it when I don't care how I look.
How would you like to...
Yes. Want to come along, Bert? We'll show you the town.
No, thanks. I gotta go home and see what the wife's doing.
Family man.
George, Terry, you're shaking the house down. Stop it.
Oh, let them alone. I wish I was up there with them.
Well, Harry O'Terry's dinner suit. George!
That's why all children should be girls.
Well, if they were all girls, there wouldn't be any... Oh, never mind. George, Harry, come down to dinner this minute. Everything's getting cold, and you know how long we've been waiting for you. Oh, you two idiots. George, sit down and have dinner.
I've eaten.
Well, aren't you going to finish dressing for your graduating party? Look at you.
I don't care. It's George's tux. Annie, my sweet, have you got those pies?
You lay a hand on me, I'll hit you with this broom.
Annie, I'm in love with you. There's a moon out tonight.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy, my last meal in the old Bailey boarding house.
Oh, my land, my blood pressure.
Pop, can I have the car? I've got to take over a lot of plates and things.
What plates?
Oh, Mom, I'm chairman of the Eats Committee. We only need a couple of dozen.
Oh, no, you don't, Harry. Now, not my best Hamlet.
Let him have the plates, will there?
Hope you have a good trip, George. Uncle Billy and I are going to miss you.
Miss you too, Pop. What's the matter? You look tired.
Oh, I had another tussle with Potter today. Uh-huh. I thought when we put him on the board of directors, he'd ease up on us a little bit.
Well, what's eating that old money-grubbing buzzard anyway?
Oh, he's a sick man. Frustrated, sick in his mind, sick in his soul, if he has one. He hates everybody that has anything that he can't have. Hates us mostly, I guess.
Yeah, gangway, gangway. So long, Pop.
So long.
Oh, you got a match?
Very funny, very funny.
Put those things in the car, and I'll get your tie and studs ready for you. Now, hurry up.
Okay, Mom.
Now,
you coming later?
Drop one of them.
You coming later, George?
What do you mean? I'd be bored to death?
Wouldn't want a better death. Lots of pretty girls. We're going to use that new floor tonight, too.
Oh, over at work.
No gin tonight, son.
Oh, Pop, just a little?
No, sir, not one drop.
Boys and girls and music. Why do they need gin?
Well, Did I act like that when I graduated from high school?
Pretty much. You know, George, I wish we could send Harry to college with you. Your mother and I talked it over half the night.
Mm. We have that all figured out. See, Harry will take my job in the building alone, work there for 4 years, and then he'll go.
Pretty young for that job.
Well, no younger than I was.
Well, you were born older, George.
How's that?
I say you were born older. I suppose you've decided what you want to do when you get out of college.
Oh, well, you know what I've always talked about. Build things, design new buildings, plan modern cities. All that stuff I've been talking about.
Still after that first million before you're 30, huh?
No, I'll sell half that in cash.
Of course, it's just a hope, but you wouldn't consider coming back to the building alone, would you?
Well, I'd... Well, Annie, why don't you draw up a chair? Then you'd be more comfortable and you could hear everything that's going on.
I would if I thought I'd hear anything worth listening to.
You would. I know it's soon to talk about it.
No, now, Pop, I couldn't. I couldn't face being cooped up for the rest of my life in a shabby little office. No, I'm sorry, Pop. I didn't mean that. It's this business of nickels and dimes and spending all your life trying to figure out how to save 3 cents in a length of pipe. I'd go crazy. I want to do something big and something important.
You know, George, I feel that in a small way we're doing something important. It's satisfying a fundamental urge. It's deep in the race for a man to want his own roof and walls and fireplace. And we're helping him get those things in our shabby little office.
I know, Pop. I know that. I wish I felt that I've been hoarding pennies like a miser here in order to... Most of my friends have already finished college. I just feel like if I didn't get away, I'd bust.
Mm-hmm. Yes. You're right, son.
You see what I mean, don't you, Pop?
This town is no place for any man unless he's willing to crawl to Potter. Now, you've got talent, son. I've seen it. You get yourself an education and get out of here.
Pop, you want a shock? I think you're a great guy. Why, did you hear that, Annie?
I heard it. It's about time one of you lunkheads said it.
I'm gonna miss old Annie. Pop, I think I'll get dressed and go over to Harry's party.
Have a good time, son.
George,
I'm
going
to put him through college.
Hello,
George. Yeehaw.
Uh-oh, Sam Wainwright. How are you? When'd you get here?
Oh, this afternoon. I thought I'd give the kids a treat.
Old college graduate now.
Yeah, old Joe College Wainwright, they call me. Well, freshman, looks like you're going to make it after all, huh? Hey, Harry, you're the
Hello,
guy
Sam.
I want to see. The coach has heard all about you.
He has?
Yeah, he's followed every game, and his mouth's watering. He wants me to find out if you're going to come along with us.
Yeah, well, I got to make some dough first.
Well, you better make it fast. We need great ends like you. Not broken down old guys like this one, huh?
George, welcome back.
Oh, McMurtry,
Putting a pool under this floor is a great idea. Saved us another building. Now, Harry, Sam, have a lot of fun. The girls just there to eat and drink. A lot of pretty girls around.
Oh, don't worry about the girls.
Hello, Violet.
Hello. What am I doing?
George.
Marty! Well, it's all homework.
Marty!
Sam, Harry,
good to see you.
Do me a favor, will you, George?
What's that?
Will you remember my kid sister, Mary?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm going to want you, Marty. Marty, remember
that. Dance with her, will you?
Oh, me? Oh, I feel funny enough already with all these kids.
Oh, come on, be a sport. Just dance with her one time and you'll give her the thrill of her life. Hey, Sam!
Oh, go ahead. Don't be long, Marty. I'm not being
winter. Next thing I knew, some guy came up and tripped me. That's the reason why I came in fourth. If it hadn't have been for that, that race had been a cinch. I tried to find out who it was later, but I couldn't find out. Nobody'd ever tell you whoever it was because they'd be scared. They know what
you
kind of a guy
George.
I am.
You remember, George. This is Mary. Well, I'll be seeing you.
Well.
Now, to get back to my story, see? Hey, this is my dance.
Oh, why don't you stop annoying me?
Well, I'm sorry. Hey!
Hello.
You look at me as if you didn't know me.
Well, I don't.
You pass me on the street almost every day.
Me? Mm-hmm. Oh, no, that was a little girl named Mary Hatch. That wasn't you.
Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, the big Charleston contest. The prize, a genuine loving cup. Those not tapped by the judges will remain on the floor. Let's go.